Hey guys, Potatomic Whiskey here, and welcome to Let's Play Civilization 6, the Outback Tycoon. And this is a Deity run. We are trying to get 900 gold per turn. Now, I don't need to explain how difficult that's going to be, considering we are about 40-ish turns into this, and we have 76 gold per turn. Now, we aren't doing too bad, but this is definitely a challenging... this is definitely a challenging scenario, and I'm pretty excited here. What I am actually going to do is I'm going to dip in for... I'm going to change this because I do need to pick up irrigation for certain things. And then I'm going to go for flight and then advanced flight. And then that's going to more or less cover everything I'm wanting to do here. So we're going to choose a civic here. The only thing we can research is the Great War, which we're going to stick on. So we have 8 turns to get these cities ready to be producing AIF trainings just consistently, so we can crank out as much of that as possible. So we need to do a lot in that time. For example, we're going to want to get our stock exchanges out. We're going to want maybe to try and get hangars out. I don't know if we're going to go for hangars. That might not be the thing we do. It's possible we do it, but we are going to need more traders, because right now our trade routes are where, like, Perth to 2D. Yeah, we need to do... We need to, like, do a little trade route shenanigans. You're ready to just power through this growth, aren't you? Yes. We want to unlock all these tiles. And here's 2DA. You're going to need another one of these grazier guys. Oh, you're too expensive for me to buy right now. You can't actually disimprove that. You head over there and improve that then. You could get this sugar online. Requires irrigation. We don't have irrigation right now. Make your way over there anyway. Market. Yeah, we're going to want to pick up market, but we're also going to want to pick up a power plant. Took 2 turns off that. Excellent. We have here Geralton. So drop a fishing boat there. We're mostly for the housing, so this place can grow like crazy. We do have 5 citizens. So it's probably about time you worked on a commercial hub. +7 on that tile. We have a lot going on here in terms of these things. What are they, the outback stations? A little bit mentally rusty here as I'm trying to get back into this scenario. It's been a while since I've played, so my brain has to readjust to what's even possible in here. We get this pasture online. Awesome. And then they should make it over there to do these 2. Now you have like 2 pretty fairly reasonable tiles to work. They're not amazing, but they're reasonable. They're fairly reasonable. Actually, here's a good one. You should get that online for the city. Use your final build, and then you'll go over here and get this kind of trio online. Unity's orders. I think I'm kind of done with explorers, more or less. I don't really have any more cities to settle, right? I have 1 more city to settle, and that's about it. And I'm probably just gonna like throw it down over here somewhere. Okay, so we have economics, so that's gonna be something we're gonna be doing, is getting the markets and stuff. Now, how are you on production? You're pretty light on production. You are not in a shortage of tiles. You're still making your way over to the gold. I could grab a market here, that would be reasonable. I don't think a shipyard is reasonable. It doesn't come out fast enough for it to be useful, in my opinion. A market could be good here. We don't need housing. We have all the important tiles online, I think. More or less. We could just use it like another grazier just to fill out the tiles, because you are going to be working stuff. So do you have a trader, Albany? There's a good question. No, you don't. Why don't you get me a trader? You can get them in a reasonable amount of time. And how about you, Bunbury? You definitely don't have a trader, so why don't you get me a trader? Oh, I can't. Not for a few turns. You did just finish your commercial hub. What are you struggling with? You need tile improvements. And lots of them. Why don't you grab me? I think a grazier here makes sense. Do a bit of grazing around here and stuff. Get these two tiles online at least. How about this? Why don't we grab a farmer? And use that farmer to chop out some of this garbage in the way. Watermill. I don't think the watermill makes sense here. I think you actually do just go for the market. Yeah, go for the market. Try and get that out. No. Now make a grazier. Go up here. Go that way. Yeah, we're not really discovering anything new here. I mean, there's no like tribal villages. There's nothing really particularly interesting that we need to like worry about as far as I can tell. That's a great tile. Make your way over there, get those online. Get this online. That's your last charge, right? Okay, you go use your last charge over there. Or rather, oh, I should have put you on the there, yeah. That would have made more sense. Okay, you have that online. Get this fish online also. It's the end of that turn. Explorer has suffered damage. At this point, I don't think that really matters. I think explorers are a little bit irrelevant to where we are in the game. Okay, York. What did you finish? You finished a harbor. Excellent. That's really good, actually, that you did that thing. But I need you to get a trader. But you can't make a trader in a reasonable amount of time. So that's a problem. Get into that forest or jungle. You're going to do some fun stuff for me, and it's probably going to be a prospector. Although you already have enough tiles to not worry about things. I have you focus on these. Right. Now. I could grab a trader. That's way too many turns, though. I don't need a naturalist. I kind of just want a trader here. Could I purchase a trader next turn? I could purchase a trader next turn. And then just get you to make prospector. Prospector. Yeah, prospector would be good. Doing a little bit of exploring with these guys. Like, you know, I could just put them to sleep, but I may as well explore the map. For whatever reason. Okay. Outback station here. Yeah, that makes reasonable amounts of sense. It's not like a catch-all amazing tile, but it's a pretty damn decent tile. And we should be able to harvest this. Or yeah, a very big boost to the power plant. And that power plant's going to be worth a lot here. This one is also worth a lot. It's going to take a few turns to get that finished. Unit needs orders. Get this fish online. The city has, you know, fairly good tiles on its cards. Get that mine online. Not really workable, but maybe. Last turn we switch everything to gold. Okay, let's send you. So does Fremantle have a trade route? No, but it doesn't need one. Bunbury could use one. Yeah, Bunbury and York could use a trade route. So why don't you go to York? Help York out. Fremantle, can you get that stock exchange? You could. You could also get some of these, but I think the stock exchange is the big money, so get that. Jump up here. Jump there. Jump there. Get the farm online. Alright, nice. I'm pretty satisfied about these tiles that I'm getting. They're lots of cattle. I think one thing you could definitely criticize me, I think I went overboard here. I did not need to do this. This was entirely unnecessary in the grand scheme of things. I could have easily saved a bunch of graziers for other cities. I could have played this a lot more efficient. I was kind of, even though I'm trying to win, I was still kind of screwing around a little bit. Are there any mining resources I need to get online? There are gems. And if I harvest that out, another grazier, and start getting things online for me over here. This will be a great tile soon, when I start dropping the other stuff near it. You have one grazier, you have one farmer. You could probably use a... They could start working on your market and stuff. Drop that there. We'll drop a farm thing there, or a outback station, and then another pasture, and then start working on this over here. Do a little exploring. There's silver. I think I could probably trade resources actually for amenities, and I might do that. Let me see here. Make deal. They're not interested. How about you? They're also not interested. Already checked you. They have silver. What would you take for silver? 100 gold for silver. That would be pretty okay. I would only get 20 turns value out of it. So, if I were to do this again, I would make my trade deals around turn 30. If I was getting maximum value out of this. I think that's definitely worth it though, because it could be, you know, 5% production in a lot of my cities. So that 100 gold is painful to lose that 100 gold, but it's also kind of necessary. Purchase a prospector, grazier. See here. Yeah, you could use a fisher, clean up your act. We'll send this to Perth. How's Perth doing? Do you need improved tiles? You could use a farmer. Got a little bit of improved stuff going on over here. Okay. 2DA? I don't really know how to say it. We have a market here. Does that make sense to make a market? Yeah, it does, I think. Make it to that forest. That tile is amazing, even without improvements. Let's see here. Geraldton. Someone else is going to build your trader. You could do it a farmer. Drop stuff out. I think there's another strategy where you send a farmer and a couple. Send a settler and a farmer out here. Settle here and then just chop out as many AIF projects as possible. That could work too. Get up onto there. Got the outback station. Very nice. Yeah, that's definitely a top tier tile right there. I want to make sure you're actually you're focusing production and food. Yeah, that's what we need most. We can worry about gold a little bit later. Gold is nice now, but it doesn't quite have the importance as it does towards the end of the scenario. When the time to score, like, are we winning coming up? Okay. So we just got Albany's trade route, which I think was for Bunbury. Yeah, and then Perth finished what? A market. That's gonna make a bank as well. And so you're gonna make a market. go there, get this salt online. I want to have like bonus amenities because the 5% gold is going to be really, really nice. So I want as many amenities as I can get. So I want to look for amenities I don't have. Like, here's wine, here's diamonds, here's tea. I think I have tea down here though somewhere. Yeah, I just need to get it online. So what I'm actually going to do here is a little unconventional. That gypsum I would really like to get, so I might settle for the gypsum, but it's hard to justify. Where are you growing to? You're growing to this absolute garbage tile over here. Because it's your only option. I would really enjoy it if you got me that gypsum. Getting gypsum, it would be really good to get it. I don't think I have a way to get it unless I were to... 1, 2, 3. It's very hard to get that gypsum. I think we might just have to give up on the gypsum. I think I will. Are there two... Do I have pearls? I think I have pearls down here. So I want to try and maximize. I'm going to get wine with a farmer up here on this farmer in particular, actually. And I think I'm going to chop out a... What am I going to chop out here? It'll be a very good industrial hub somewhere. Like there? Get these mines up? Ooh, that's a hard decision to make. Even just for the industrial hub and the workshop, that would be probably worth it. It's hard to decide. Let's see. York, what do you need? You could use a commercial hub. For the gold. This miner has a bit of work to do. Namely, making his way up to... this place. I don't want to chop out this market. It doesn't seem worth it, but it might be worth it. What if I chopped out a trader? That feels much better to me. And then getting the market in one turn anyway. Send this to Perth. So what else could I build in Perth in terms of... not much. The only last thing would be an airport, which I could actually start airports before I hit... before I hit the Great War, which would actually be huge if I could get some airports out before I hit the Great War. I don't know if I'll be able to pull that off though. Yeah, we're doing really nicely. We're gonna chop here next turn. Light aerodomes. So let's see here, we have airports and a hangar. Drop the aerodrome. Okay, we need to start thinking really hard about what we're doing next. What are you working? You're working a fairly decent tile, actually. I think my pastures are getting boosted now from adjacencies. So let me refresh all these guys, make sure everyone's on the right settings. The city's gonna be crazy. Yeah, look at this. This is absurd amounts of production right here in the city. 50 production per turn. That's absurdity. That's absolute insanity, that level of production. So Bunbury here, what could you make for me? You could get me an aerodrome. I would not be against this decision. I don't want to stick it there because it's adjacent. Here would be okay because I'd get a bonus out of it. Drop this guy here and then connect these two up. Claim some of this land. Keep scouting around. I'm just kind of wasting my time on those guys. Oh, do I want to chop that out? No, I think I'll chop for the bank. Because the bank is going to take longer anyway. Get that online. That's important that we get that online. Okay, now you're going to be... So who's lacking a trade route right now? Perth has one. 2D has one. I think Fremantle lacks one. Geralton lacks one, so let me drop you over there in Geralton or whatever it's called. Get this online. They're not amazing tiles, but they're improvements, I guess. I don't know why I did that. Yeah, I think ignoring fishing outside of luxuries is the way to go in this scenario. That's what it feels like. It feels like fishing is worthy of ignoring. Maybe early game it's worth a little bit of screwing around with it. Okay, I want to crush like a bad... Here's a bad one over there. So this is... It doesn't give adjacency bonuses to any of these. It's a pretty terrible tile. Get the aerodrome out here. Nice. Okay, so we have 2DA. We have an aerodrome. We can start purchasing... How's your tiles looking? You're working some unimproved. Purchase yourself a grazier. Get to work on a hangar. How are you doing? How are you doing? Start on a bank. See here, Bunbury. So here's a little bit of extra amenities now. A lot of thinking going here in my head as I'm trying to solve this puzzle. We have a lot of gold per turn, and we're one turn from hitting the Great War. So we're gonna have to start thinking real hard about what we do here. I think the idea of sending a settler up here and then chopping out a bunch of forests to get IAF projects, I think that's a reasonable thing to do to spend our money on. We're kind of just busy working some of these things. Send that to Albany. I would like a road, however. So go to 2DA. And let's have a look around here. We're kind of just random exploring. They still haven't settled all their cities. I should be far ahead, technically. If this was a multiplayer game, I would be dominating, I feel. I have so much of the map. My cities are spaced out. My cities have so many great improvements. Okay, so the World War I, the Great Effect. The Great War afflicts the continent of Europe, and our mother country of Britain has been thrown into the fray. We will send troops to lend our support. You may now initiate the AIF project in any of your cities. Each such contribution you make to the war effort will enhance your state standing in our nation, earning you more gold per turn. Okay, so this is some pretty important stuff that's going to be happening here. We're going to be getting rid of... We're going to be slotting in this AIF project thing. And it's probably going in the place of that for now. But we're still going to want graziers and farmers. So let's see. This is 123 production. Takes 3 turns for plus 7 gold. We have a look at the commercial hub. This could be worth it. Like, let me see here, right? If I just said to the city, ignore food, go for gold. It could up its gold quite a bit from that. So it might be worth it to build this stock exchange for 3 turns. Because this is 3 turns for potentially 11 score. This is 2 turns for 10 score. So I'm going to build a stock exchange, even though I'm not entirely sure that's the right decision. And I think here, the Flying Doctors is the dream. Wait, who builds airstrips? We see here air strip. Oh, a prospector builds airstrips. Do I have a prospector laying about here? Yeah, I'll use you next turn to build an airstrip. So we have free mantle here. Questions. Hangar for 3 turns. You're doing AIF training. You're also doing AIF training. You're doing AIF training. Get chopping. Drop that there. Nice. Okay. Get ready to chop here. You'll do. Yeah, you'll get that out of the way. Outback station. Can we put those on a hill? Good question. We'll find out now soon. Grab that over there. We have a settler. Now the question is, we have some pretty big questions about what we do with this settler. We could settle it up here in this forest and then just do like crazy amounts of chopping. And that appeals to me. Or we could settle for the gypsum. I'm on board with the chopping plan. I want to get somewhere where I'm going to get a lot of chops. And I want to get there fast. And that's not really an option. 1, 2, 3. This is our best option right there. Maybe. Seven turns to there. That'll do it. Next turn. Unit needs orders. I think I'm going to start putting my explorers on sleep so I can save my mental resources for the task at hand. But that's going to be it for this episode. I want to thank you very much for watching. I think we have a chance at getting a very high score. I think we achieved a 384 score. But I have a couple of ideas and strategies that I'm going to try to employ to approach that 900. We got to about Warlord. But I want to go for, I'm going for the Deity. I'm hoping to hit at least Prince or King levels of gold per turn. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please remember, if you want to see more episodes of this series or series like it, I will be doing I have a very cool idea for an Australia, like a playthrough of the Australia Civ. So stay tuned for that. So if you want to see more of that, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, if you want to directly support my channel, give me some love and feedback and help me, please leave a like on the video. It increases my rank. It makes me more visible on YouTube, all that good stuff. And if you want to give me direct feedback about this episode or anything you want to talk about, give me suggestions, questions, or requests. Or even if you just want to say something to me, call me an asshole in chat. That's fine. Just leave a comment on the video. But that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoying this, because I'm having a lot of fun, actually. Like really trying to figure this out. But I love you all very much, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye-bye.